Today we're going to talk about something new and different, the Manta M4P version 2.1. Now, as you can see above the Manta, there's different compute modules. So we have a CB1, we have the CM4 modules, and then we have a CM4 with eMMC, which connect to the board so you can integrate the computer into your motherboard for printing. So I'm going to explain the basics of this board real quick and then show you how to actually load the firmware. So first of all, we have our GPIO pins up here. These would be the general purpose input output pins. Now they use a different designation. They call them SOC IO pins. So it's basically general purpose input output pins. Over in here, we've got a couple of different pins. We've got our UART pins. We also have our SPI pins, and then we have our RGB2 pins in this section, as well as an SWD set of pins. So I'm not going to point to each one. I'll show you in a moment on the diagram what they are. Then we have our extruders. So we have our E0. Then we have our X stepper, our Y stepper, and our Z stepper. Over in here, we have our end stops for X, Y, and Z. And then we have a runout detector that we can use over in here. Over in here, you can see that there's two ZIF connectors. What these are ribbons that run to either the display or to the camera. I don't know which is which from what I'm seeing right here, but then we have our USB hub or third USB connection, and then we have two more over in here. Our connection to the board, if we want to connect to it, we have a 5-volt connection that we have to set up with the jumper over in here, but do not use that when using TMC type steppers. You'll want to use main power. So the power actually is here, and I believe it's 24 volts. And then we have power over in here that is for, hang on, let me look this up real quick. That is actually for the stepper motors. So this can go to 48 volts with a jumper setting up in here. Also, we have the output for our heat bed and our extruder. Then down in here, we have our HDMI port, our EXP 1 and 2, if I haven't already said that. And then a connector over here, which is a general purpose input output ZIF cabling configuration. Over in here, we have our BL Touch connector that we can use. We have our thermistors down in here. And then this one, I'm not sure of off the top of my head, so I'll have to look that up. And I believe that is some type of fan port right here, as well as these three fans that we have here that run off the power as well. Obviously, there's another RGB, I think, right here. But let me check real quick. That's actually, I guess, a Z driver. So that might be an additional driver for your NEMA steppers, which are these up in here. So, as you know, we've got fuses on the board like normal. And then, of course, we have dip switches. If we're using the eMMC module, we're going to have to change 3 and 4 in order to connect to it with a special binary program. And then, of course, we have a reset switch, but usually I power cycle in order to use that. So, we also have the Ethernet over here if I haven't already said it. And if I flip this over, there's a couple of more things you need to know. Over in here is where we're going to load our firmware. They've already created the firmware for us, and so it doesn't have any variations. It connects directly to the board. Obviously, here is the processor. This is a STM32G0B0, I believe, and it runs at, I think, 48 megahertz. Then the MCU will be loaded via this drive right here, which is the firmware. And then of course, if we want to run a regular Raspberry Pi configuration for like Octoprint or Clipper, we'd run it through here. With the eMMC, we don't need to use this actual port. So I'm going to show you how to load this real quick. So in order to do this, we need to use an adapter to connect in here. So I'm going to connect this like so. Then I'm going to connect this over in here and plug this into the computer. On the computer, I'll now show you the actual configuration that we want to work with. So normally this will be used for Clipper. Clipper is currently the only firmware that I know that works with this board. Maybe in the future it will work with Marlin, but presently it does not. So if we go over to the BigTree GitHub page, we can get information on this board by clicking over here, typing Manta, and then we have our M4P. If we click on this, we can download this right here by clicking on download. That will pull it down to our computer where we can extract it and have all this information. But I'm going to show you real quick what's in here. So if we click on Clipper firmware, you can see that it's got the firmware and then it's got the printer config files. They've named them for you for each type of printer that you would work with. This one's generic. This one's for a particular printer, obviously. So now that we know that, I already have this downloaded to my computer, so I'll show you how to load it in just a moment. But I want to show you a couple other things. You're going to need TerraTerm, which will allow you to communicate with your printer board via a SSH session, which is secure shell. FileZilla is good for putting files on or taking them off if you decide to build your own version of Clipper. Then we have the Raspberry Pi Imager. This will allow you to image your drive. You can download it, and this will be helpful to create images that you can use either directly on the eMMC or on the drive on the board. Then, of course, we have Cura that we can use for slicing, and it's a free download as well. So that covers most of what you're going to need. I want to show you also that I created a small definition of things. This is actually for the M8P, which is the other Manta. And of course, there's a bunch of acronyms in here that I've explained a little bit. I'll place this up on Patreon for people that want to view it. So now that we've got that covered, I also have to understand, or let you understand, that we also have other functionality, such as Discord, which I'll bring up here. And I created a bunch of rooms where you can actually ask computer questions. So as you can see in here, we have a general open chat. Then we also have YouTube requests. We have BigTree Tech TFT displays, print quality, BL Touch. Then we have Share Your Designs and Clipper. So you can ask questions in here, and most people are more than happy to answer them. So let me minimize that for a second. Now what I'll talk about is actually how to image the drive. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to go over to the Downloads folder. And inside here, we're going to go to the Manta. Inside the Manta, we're going to go to the firmware file, Clipper. And I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to send it to our drive, which is right over in here. If I can send it to the right drive, pardon me, do that again. So I'm going to right click and I'm going to send it to our firmware drive. So if you look over in here, you'll see firmware-USB and firmware.cur in all capital letters. That was the last successful load of the firmware. So we actually have to rename this because it's not named correctly. So it's going to be firmware.bin is the actual name. So let's go over to the desktop and actually load this. So I'm going to pop out the drive. I'm going to place it inside of here. I'm going to flip the board back over. Pardon my alignment. And then I'm going to place a jumper here so we can power the board. This allows us to have 5 volts of power. So I'll connect this, there'll be a quick flash of a light, and that is the firmware loading. So as you can see, it just happened. So I'm going to unplug it, pull out the drive so we can verify it actually loaded, and place this back in the computer so you can see what's going on. So on the computer, if we go to the actual drive, give me a second here to actually open it. So we'll do this to get around this for the moment. Go to our actual firmware. You can see that it loaded and the time has changed from firmware.bin when we just loaded it. So in future tutorials, I'll cover how to load the actual operating systems for each one of these boards and the different ways to do it. I also want to take a moment to ask you to like and subscribe so this actually informs others, as well as I will place a thank you note at the end of the tutorial for all the patrons as well as the people on PayPal that have donated to make this possible. And I also want to thank Big Tree Tech for providing the actual Manta M4P version 2.1 as well as the CB1 module for the tutorials. So everyone take care, thank you, and I'll talk to you later.